Good morning students. Already we learnt squares and square roots in previous classes. So today we are going to see about the topic of chapter number 7, cubes and cube roots. First one, what's cubes? Cube has all sides length equal. This is the cube. It's all sides length are equal. So now we using number system. So we'll take any one number, for example 1. Its cube is 1 is multiplied by 3 times 1 into 1 into 1 to get 1. Next we take 2. This number also multiply by 3 times. Why here multiply by 3 times? 3, it means cube. So you will multiply these 2 3 times, 2 into 2 into 2. See here, 2 into 2 into 2, that is equal to 8. So 2 cube is equal to 8. So 8 is a perfect cube. Perfect cube. Next we take 3. 3 is multiplied by 3 times. 3 into 3 into 3 to get 27, and so on. So we'll take the number and cube also, find the another numbers. So next see the example. Find the ones digit of cube of 3331. So this is left side and this one right side. So we'll start from right. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Here asking ones digit. Which is ones digit? So one is the ones digit. So we take ones digit of 3331. So ones digit is 1. Now find the ones digit of cube. Cube, it means 1 multiplied by 3 times. That is the cube of ones digit. Cube of ones digit. 1 cube. That is equal to 1. 1 into 1 into 1. To get 1 into 1, 1. 1 into 1, 1. Answer also 1. So the ones digit of the cube of 3331 is 1. Next see the examples. Is 243 a perfect cube? Perfect cube, it means first we take frame factorization by this method. So 243, see its ending digit odd number, so we'll divide any odd number. So we'll take 3. 24, we'll take 24. How many times 3 in 24? 8 times. 3 8s are 24. Next one, 3 ones are 3. Next 81, this number also divided by 3. 3 2s are 6, so carry 2. Carry 2, it means 21. So 3 7s are 21. Next 27, it's divided by, it's also divided by odd number because its ending digit is odd, so we'll divide by 3. 3 9s are 27. Next see the 9 also odd number, so 3 3s are 9. Next 3 1s are 3. Now 1 2 3 4 5. 5 times 3, so 243 is equal to 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Here 5 times, so we'll write here 5 times, right, 3. So next we take cube. Cube, it means groove. 3 3 number, but here only 2 number. So in the above factorization, 3 into 3 remains after grouping the 3's in triplets. This one triplets. Triplets, it means 3 times, but 3 into 3 is not a triplet, only square. This one only square, because here given only 2 numbers. 243 is not a perfect square. Suppose you will multiply another 1 3, it means it is a perfect cube. Now 243 is not a perfect cube. Next, see the second sum. Is 392 a perfect cube? If not, find the smallest natural number by which 392 must be multiplied so that the product is the perfect cube. So first we take prime factorization, 392, by using division method. So 392, its ending digit is even number, so we'll divide it by 2. 2 ones are 2, carry 1, so we'll write here 19. So 2 9s are 18, carry 1, now it is considered as 12. 2 6 are 12. Next, its ending digit also even number, so divided by 2. We'll take 19. How many times 2 in 19? 9 times. 2 9s are 18, carry 1, now it is considered as 16. 2 8s are 16. Next, see its ending digit also even number, so it's also divided by 2. 2 4s are 8, carry 1, 18. 2 9s are 18. 49 is will come 7th table, so 7 into 7. Now 2 2 2, how many times? 1 2 3 times, so write 2 in 3 times, and 7 write in 2 times. Now group the 3 3, it's one group because it has 3 times, but 7 does not appear in the group of 3, only 2. So 392 is not a perfect cube. To make its cube, we need one more 7. So you will multiply here 392 into 7, and here also multiply by 7. 2 into 2, see here, 2 into 2 into 2, 7 into 7 into 7. Now it is group of triplet. So 392 into 7 to get 2744 is a perfect cube. So if not, find the smallest number by which 392 must be multiplied. So which number multiplied to 392 to get perfect square? 7. So hence the smallest number, natural number, by which 392 should be multiplied to make a perfect cube is 7. Next, see the third sum. Is 53,240 a perfect cube? So here also find the prime factorization method. So 53,240, see its ending digit even number, so 0 is the even number, so we'll divide it by 2. 2 2s are 4, carry 1, now it is considered as 13. How many times 2 in 13? 2 6 are 12, so 13 minus 12 to get 1, so carry 1, so now it is considered as 12. 2 6 are 12. Next, 2 2s are 4, then 0. Next, its ending digit also 0, so divided by 2. 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, 2 3s are 6. Next, 2 1s are 2, next 0. Here ending digit also 0, so this number also divided by 2. So 1 is not possible, so we will take 13. 2 6 are 12, so 13 minus 12 carry 1, so we'll write here 2 1, so now it is considered as 13. 2 6 are 12, so carry 1, now it is considered as 11. 2 5s are 10, next carry 1, now it is considered as 10. 2 5s are 10, its ending digit 5, so we'll divide it by 5. How many times 5 6? 1 time, so 5 1s are 5, 6 minus 5 carry 1, Now it is considered as 16. 5 threes are 15. 16 minus 15, carry 1. Now it is considered as 15. 5 threes are 15. How many times 5 in 5? 1 time. Its ending digit odd. So we'll divide 11th table. 11, so it is considered as 13. 11 into 1, 11. So 13 minus 11, carry 2. Now it is considered as 23. 11 into 2, 22. Carry 1. Now it is considered as 11. How many times 11? Only 1 time. Next, 121. 11 into 11, 121. So 53,240, that is equal to 2, 1, 2, 3 times. 11, 1, 2, 3 times. And 5, only 1 time. So here 5 is not appear in a group of 3. So 53,240 is not a perfect cube. If we divide by 5, then the number. So suppose we will divide it by 5, it means 5 cancel. Not only divide this side also divided by 5. So 53,240 is divided by 5 and here also divided by 5. Now divide 5, 5 cancel. 53,240 is divided by 5, that is equal to 10,648. Now 2, 3 times, 11, 3 times. So it is the group of 3. So 10,648 is a perfect cube. That's all for the day.